What's up, guys? Dante, aka Game Thief and Roll Games, here, back giving you yet another Drama Scripted. And if you're new here, or if you're not new here, please subscribe, because chances are, if this is your third or fourth or fifth time seeing those videos, you're probably not subscribed, because it's easy to miss, or you're just used to seeing the Facebook or the Twitter. But please, please, please subscribe to the channel. We're at 177. We're trying to make it to 200 before WrestleMania, so would you please just stop, take a time out to subscribe to the channel. It helps the channel a lot. Thank you very much. But on this week's episode of Drama Scripted, we are going to do a small review of the Elimination Chamber, and the ratings will be in the comment section below me, so please sure to check that out for all the ratings on this past week's shows. So let's see, we had the Women's Elimination Chamber. It had Asuka, Carmella, Liv Morgan, Nikki Cross, and Rochelle Rodriguez, and Natty. And it won. The winner of that match wound up to be Asuka, which, you know, they low-key have been, they've been giving Asuka some light. They brought back her katana era from Stardom. So for those of you who don't know, she's the sick or sad clown. She's beginning more ruthless, more of establishing the ring. And it showed in the Elimination Chamber. She won the match. I was rooting for Raquel Rodriguez, because it seems that WWE is doing this thing where it seems like they want Rodriguez to be like a top babyface for the women's division. And she keeps getting so close. And then like something just doesn't happen where she either loses the title match or loses the number one contenders match. But she's just always in the mix somehow. It's almost like they did with Liv Morgan. Like 2 years ago, and then they finally gave Liv her championship. Speaking of Liv, I guess they're just gonna, Liv's new thing is just keep passing out with a smile on her face, because she was putting the Asuka lock and she was putting the sharpshooter at the same time, and she didn't tap out. She passed out yet again. So I'm just gonna assume that's just Liv's new thing. She's not gonna give up. She's just gonna pass out. But yeah, so Asuka wins. So it's going to be Asuka versus Belair at WrestleMania 39 for the Raw Women's title. Next match, Bobby Lashley, Brock Lesnar. This match was dead ass less than 5 minutes. The total time for this match was 4 minutes and 45 seconds. And Bobby Lashley defeated Brock Lesnar by disqualification. So they're going to do some crazy shit at WrestleMania. That's all I could think of. Like, there's just going to be some crazy stipulation at WrestleMania to just solve this thing once and forever. That's just where I'm going to go with this. That's where I'm going to go. So after that, we had Edge and Beth Phoenix versus Finn Balor and Rhea Ripley. Both of them got their spots, Edge and Beth Phoenix both having the educator locked on in the middle of the ring. Fantastic match, and I was actually surprised that Edge and Beth got the win. I know Finn took the pin, but it's like it's so close to like WrestleMania. I wouldn't think you would put Rhea in any type of losers category, but yeah, Edge and Beth Phoenix got the win, and I guess this feud with Edge and Beth Phoenix and Judgment Day is over. So there's that. Then we had the U.S. title Elimination Chamber, Austin Theory, Bronson Reed, Damian Priest, Johnny Gargano, Montez Ford, and Seth freaking Rollins. And Montez Ford was brilliant throughout this match. I like how they all had the tag team up on Bronson Reed to get Bronson Reed to get him out of there. He was the first person eliminated, even though he was the second to last person in. So, which is, actually, no, he was the last person. No, second to last. Monster Ford was last. So, yeah, that was crazy. But, you know, get the big man out first, the tag team on him. Johnny Gargano and Seth. Johnny Gargano and Seth. We need that somewhere down the line as a singles match. Because the way they kicked off that Elimination Chamber was fantastic. I need a solo match with those two. That was fantastic. That was great. Final two came down to Seth freaking Rollins and Austin Theory, and your boy Logan Paul showed up, did a buckshot lariat. I think Hangman might have to retire and stop doing that move, because Logan Paul is performing Hangman's finisher better than Hangman, and Logan Paul's been doing it in less time. So that's just crazy to me. But Logan Paul's buckshot lariat is flawless. I can't hate. Like, I know a lot of people don't like Logan Paul, but mans could wrestle. And you wouldn't think from Logan Paul, all the shenanigans and the exhibition fights and then his real fights and then all his YouTube channel and the fucked up shit he did in Japan, you wouldn't think that mans could actually wrestle. Mans could wrestle. Man, mans can wrestle good. Like it almost hurts a lot of people to say, but Logan Paul, for a short amount of time that he's been doing it, Logan Paul can go. Like, this is like, I want, after WrestleMania, I know Logan Paul has a busy schedule, somehow figure it out, Papa H, but get this man a full-time contract. Or like once every 2 weeks. Or like once every premium live event. Cause mans could really go. Like, he really can. So it looks like we're gonna get Seth freaking Rollins versus Logan Paul at WrestleMania 39. And it's also good that they left the title out of it, because it doesn't really need a title. So that was good. And then we have the main event, which I have a couple of gripes about. It was very emotional. Official timestamp on the match was 32 minutes and 20 seconds. So a minute, no, 90, yeah, 50 seconds shorter than the USA title belt Elimination Chamber match. The match was good, very long, drawn out, emotional. Instead, here's where I have some gripes about the ending. So, ending was, and Sammy hit a Superman punch too. But ending was, Jay came out, got the distraction, then a chair got involved, Roman hit Sammy with the chair, then a spear, and I got the 1-2-3, and then, after it's all said and done, then Kevin Owens comes out to help Sammy. Why didn't Kevin Owens come out when Jimmy came out? Like, have KO chase away Jimmy after Jimmy's already got involved. And then, like, nothing, you could just have everything else happen to him. You could have Jay come out to stop it, which he did, which caused some confusion. And then Sammy accidentally speared Jay. And then Roman went all fucking maniac on Sami Zayn's ass with the steel chair. Nothing changes if you just had KO come out to chase away Jimmy. Because now it looks kind of stupid. Why is KO coming out after the match is over? You could still keep the same finish. Just have KO come out and chase away Jimmy. Now it looks dumb when KO comes out after it's already over. Doesn't make any sense to me whatsoever. But I guess we'll get the follow-up on Friday Night SmackDown. And with that being said, this was your Drama Scripted. Remember, there'll be a Drama Scripted every week. Please be on the lookout for it. Please subscribe. Please leave a comment section on the YouTube channel, just not on the Facebook page. But until next time, guys, I'm Dante, Fiend of All Games. Later, and peace. Be safe, everyone.